Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we are for the consolation round. Airborne seems to be parking himself quite a distance away from the main pack on the start line, which is interesting.
I think it's because he's paranoid. Every time he starts, he gets bumped.
Fair enough. With me on commentary, as always, is J-Dog, who is streaming live. We have Kujo Khan, Corporal Mads, and Miodred VK. I mean,
I demand my new name.
What is that? L.
Fosh Circler.
Fosh Circler 5000. Kujo, I don't know if Kujo and Mads, have you guys done commentary with me before?
Once before, yep.
All right.
I've never done it.
All right, we're going to break that cherry. Let us commence the race. I've been killed by Curry. Death by Curry, that's kind of actually the way I've always dreamt about going out.
It's kind of sad.
We have a big kind of a pileup, Mondo, Brody.
Right. Johnny Kai is finally in the race trim and is in the lead. I swear he jumps the start. He always takes the lead.
That is
he
possible.
He claims it's clean and I'm going to believe him, but it seems a bit weird that he is always the man in front.
Well, he's always the man that breaks the rules anyway, so if we have to black flag him again, I'm not going to be surprised.
He forgot what lap he was on in that heat race.
Sure.
I do not believe that one little bit.
Confused, yeah. And possibly drunk.
That is acceptable.
They're coming up to the northern corner of the first turn where the bridge is.
Yeah, Airborne's strategy of being away from the pack hasn't worked because him and Mondo ran into each other another way back there.
Brody and Heckler were banging back there.
Ooh, Brody with a T-bone.
Around the corner. Oh, we got
Johnny Kai, Arthur. Then it's Heckler and Brody with Mondo and Airborne at the back.
Curry taking a really wide turn there.
Yeah, I don't know what that the deal is. It's pretty obvious you stick to the coast road. Even yeah. Johnny knows that now.
Airborne's a little wide too, but it's Airborne.
Did we issue a warning to Curry?
We'll see.
That kind of enabled him to.
Well, I don't think it would have made that
much
difference.
That
being so tight at the bridge, sometimes that's just a pure survival maneuver.
Yeah, I'm not that worried about it. If he continues
like
to break the rules.
To make a Formula One reference, the Monza first turn, where basically everyone's piling into a turn that's really not meant for it, and inevitably someone breaks the rules.
Yeah. If he continues to break rules and take wide corners, then we will take measures.
But I think the first lap on this track is a little bit of a free pass at that corner. Not to abuse it, but...
Exactly.
He's taking off a good lead with Curry in second and Jack in third.
That would mean that we have Johnny and Curry in the hot seats to go on to the next round.
Curry taking a really, really wide corner to get to that bridge. That's an odd...
We were supposed to have another tank in this, but she has been elevated to the finals.
Indeed. Zarmal apparently has abandoned the field of battle, and therefore Zev has moved on, being the furthest qualifying or the furthest existing.
What the hell was that?
I don't know, but that was entertaining.
There. Can he get out?
I don't know. He's got 5 seconds. Four.
Do you want me to assist
he's good.
Or...
He's good.
No, he's good.
Mondo moving into not last place.
I was just thinking with me, well, he hasn't been last all day. Airborne's been pushed back. I swear Airborne's got something wrong with that tank.
Yes.
It's potentially
true.
Because
despite being like, he looks like he's optimally suited, and he's always in last.
We should probably investigate. Oh, and Jack Brody starts opening up on Curry. That is a wise maneuver at this point.
Take a run with him. Figure it out. I don't know if it's just, I don't know, maybe he doesn't have a crew that's trained for that tank.
That's potentially true. The only thing I can figure out is if maybe he's unlocked parts of things but has not actually applied them yet.
That would be the other thing.
Curry is going down.
Brody's
down
taking around out of him. 5%.
Curry's engine's out. Curry's gonna die.
This is where the whole strategy thing kind of comes in. I saw it in the first heat where you had a group of people who were qualified and like well in front deciding
Brody.
To butcher each other.
Brody and Curry just fucking fighting it out. Brody actually slowed down to try and get the kill shots. Can't do it. He's reloaded 3 times now.
Just can't get.
He needs to get the hell out of there. Brody's track is damaged.
I'm interested in doing an experiment of whether the long gun's a better option than the short gun.
Curry is down to 2 hit points.
Go,
let's see
Curry.
If Brody's just going to sprint it out.
Someone could on him and he'd be out of the race.
I think Brody's just going to sprint this out and get out of there.
Oh, he's taking fire from Curry, though.
Yeah, he is.
Down to 1%.
Curry did repair his engine.
He really needs to kill Curry.
Heckler went for a swim here at the North Bridge.
Oh, Heckler in that water. Heckler in the water.
He's
down.
Curry is down.
Courtesy of Captain Mondo.
Both of Brody's tracks are damaged.
Heckler's taking fire from airborne here at the back of the pack.
Yeah, it's
currently at the front.
Not be last. They're just too far behind.
Johnny's taking fire from Jack.
Mondo.
No, well, Mondo hasn't hit him yet. Jack's the only one hitting him.
Yeah, well, Mondo's trying.
Yeah, he is.
I admire his spunk.
Jack taking damage from Mondo.
Johnny's taking shots.
Yeah, Johnny's taking shots from Brody.
He's down to 34 hit points.
If Brody can pull this off, then he and Mondo will qualify, although they may kill each other before they get there. Oh, gas tank down. Johnny's taking all kinds of abuse here. He's got his engine still.
One more shot.
Commander down.
He doesn't kill him. I think that Johnny's tank is just too gimped.
Oh, he healed. Johnny's healed his commander. But I don't know if that's going to help him. Enough.
Oh, it'll help. I just don't know if it's going to be enough. I think Brody's closing the gap. And we know Brody's got some skills.
Yeah, he does.
It took a while for him to realize those skills, but he's got them.
Johnny admirably. Oh, Johnny down.
Down goes Johnny.
I was about to say Johnny admirably sticking to the track.
There goes Heckler as well.
Wow. So we got a field of three. And unless Mondo decides to tear Brody apart from long range, which wouldn't make any sense, we will have Mondo and Brody as our qualifiers. Airborne does have some damage to a track, but not enough to really slow him down that much. Mondo is completely unscathed, other than missing 30% health.
That's not really all that unscathed.
Mechanically, he is still sound.
Mechanically, he is functional.
So, how's the wife and kids?
Someone who has a wife and kids, why'd I ask that
question? Mance is the only
locked in the basement where they should be?
Hey-o.
Wife and kids are really good.
Why the hell is Jack Brody stuck? That guy slows way the hell down to take that corner.
He's just really nervous about that corner.
At this point, he's probably like, well, I am in first place.
Better safe than sorry.
I'd like to stay in first place.
Yep.
And not kill myself.
I'm not gonna lie, if you give the orders to kill Jack Brody, I will do it.
No. We'll get a victory lap, although Cujo, if you would move into the winner's circle so they could suicide by hitting you as hard as possible, that would
Absolutely.
Be entertaining.
Or try to do what I did.
That would be fun too.
Except you're not a Fosh.
Circle of Fosh. As long as they can cross the line, that's all that's really required.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm very tempted to do a Mario Kart with MT25s at some point.
I think we tried it out, and it was definitely interesting. Heckler is dead in the middle of the track. I'm gonna do a little. Oh, Brody hits him anyway. That's admirable that he's sticking to the line that hard, but he may be intoxicated.
You are allowed to go around corpses, just to clarify.
It's true, yes. Any hard object you don't have to try and drive through.
There's Airborne.
Airborne is pretty much a half lap back.
But how many are advancing in this round?
Only two.
Only two, okay.
Yep.
Well,
Mondo and Brody will qualify.
Yeah, without a doubt it's Mondo and Brody.
And, Mance, actually, if you want to track down Airborne, you may go weapons hot as soon as we declare first and second place.
Roger.
Just to save everyone the journey.
I will shoot him in the ass and then blame my touchpad.
Sorry, I coughed and hiccuped and farted at the same time.
And the Brody, will he take the honorable option and kill himself on Cujo?
Who knows? He is charging.
He's shooting.
It's going evasive. Serpentine. Oh!
He's taking the honorable way.
Fair enough. Well played, sir. Why don't we pull Jack Brody down here and congratulate him on his big win? Just because we don't have enough people in the media channel. Booth. Sir Brody of Jack, you have won. You have won.
I wouldn't want to race.
I would like to point out the fact that, wait, were you in third when you took out somebody, or were you in second?
I was behind.
He was second when he
killed Johnny. He was second when he killed Johnny.
He was second, Johnny, yeah.
Okay. Because, yeah,
I
you were...
good.
Yeah, you did, but you were already qualified.
Oh. It was unneeded.
It's kind of interesting. There was a lot more weird assault going on this one than there was in any other race.
Yeah, that's usually how I like to roll.
And I believe, if I'm not incorrect, that Mio, there he is. Rah!
Nice.
That brings a halt to the...
You actually got his carcass on your tank.
That brings a halt to the filming of the Constellation Round. Gentlemen, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Apparently we're starting. I don't know who opened fire, but apparently we're starting.
Okay.
I don't know what that was about. I don't think I fired at any, whatever. Who cares?
You did at one point shoot me.
Yeah, that was about 8 seconds ago. Out front, we have Ender's Tank, followed by Jack Brody, Iron Ranger, Mio Dread, Radagast, Utpek, Corporal Mance. Let me get back a little farther here. Cujo and Captain Mondo. Zev Bellringer is apparently not around. I don't know what happened there. She lined up like everyone else and then probably had to go take care of a child.
And here they come.
This is going to be
hell. The bridge.
All right. Enders takes a bit of a wide corner. Oh. Iron Ranger almost goes off. Brody and Mia are going nose to nose. Damn. Brody is basically sacrificing any chance of winning by molesting the crap out of Mio. And so Jack Brody will not win. I don't know why he does that every single time. He just grinds on anybody he can find. He will never get a win doing that. Ender's Tank way out in front. I don't think anybody's going to catch him unless he makes a huge mistake. We have Cujo in second, Mance in third, although that is a battle. Mio Dread.
Third and fourth are going at it.
Yep, I would, and Brody and Mio are still kind of battling it out for fourth and fifth, or fifth and sixth, I don't know.
Oh, man. Mio and Jack
keeps
just
trying to make
other.
It. Oh, Mondo's now getting into the hack with Mio, too.
Oh, brutal. Mio just getting horribly raped.
Oh, the second lap's going to be just terrible.
It's going to be a clusterfuck of enormous proportions. Nobody hitting the dead tank as of yet. He said, watching Jack Brody carefully.
Ender's is in the lead.
And there comes Jack Brody. Oh, just missed
Although,
that tank.
As we've already seen, Jack could potentially annihilate people.
It's true.
But
he has that potential.
I'm not so sure he can do that to Ender's.
Ender's
will have a bit too much of a lead.
Mio Dread now second from last because basically every time he gets near anybody, they just bump him into something.
Oh,
Mance
almost
hit
the wall
there.
On the bridge.
Brutal. That'll put him well within firing distance of Jack Brody, which, as we have shown in the past, likes to fire.
That little scuffle going in the back.
Oh, it's going to be quite a surprise coming around this corner. I'd better stay behind this rock.
Jack Brody moves right into third place by a neat little move coming up over that bank. Cujo opening fire on
that
Enders, but he is gone.
Firing range for Mance.
Yeah, that's true. We'll see if anybody opens fire.
Oh, and it's going to be Jack and
opening
Mance.
Fire.
Oh, and the rest of them are coming up. Fields coming up behind him. Oh.
Looks like everybody's just firing as fast
as
they can reload.
Yeah, turned around and is firing back.
Ender's Chain is coming and firing as he comes.
Mondo's going to take out Iron Ranger. Iron Ranger down, and then Mondo piles right into the back of him.
Ender's has got quite a lead here.
Yeah, he does.
Here comes Cujo coming and pulling second place.
Good. Mio, Radagast has put Mio in the wall again. Mio now taking fire from Mondo. Mondo looking for a second kill.
Jack for third. Mance. Upek. Mance. Get Upek off the bridge.
Oh, Oot into the drink.
I don't know if he's going to be able to get up on that side. I think he's going to drown. No, there's no way up. Upek down. Ooh. Mio Dread Upek in the water. Miodred tracked in the water.
As well.
I think he misjudged that corner a little bit. He's gonna. There's no way he can repair and survive. Yeah, Mio is now down. So the battle for last place comes down to Mondo and Rad. And now it's Mondo. Mondo successfully conquers last place. Congratulations. We have Jack Rhodey's...
Miodred down into here.
Let us do that thing, yes.
What?
Miodred, you were horribly molested by everybody on every turn. How do you plead? That sounds like a guilty verdict right there.
Oh.
Really molested.
Well, I said horribly molested. I don't know how much more I can qualify that.
It's still way out there.
It gets old after a while, but I'll bitch later.
Fair enough. Since it looked like every time you got near anybody, especially Jack, you got... Yeah, that happened. Pretty much that. I don't think I could punctuate that any better.
Hello. The rounds go flying.
Yeah, everybody's still opening fire on everybody at this
Mondo's
point.
Mondo's still firing on Mance.
Brody's still firing at Cujo. Zev finally connecting, although she is out of the race at this point. Impossible to win.
Depends on who survives.
Yeah, that's true. We are coming to the end of the second lap, which means weapons cold for Cujo and Ender. Weapons cold coming up for Jack as soon as he crosses the line. And Mance and Bondo will follow. So it's down to the racing. Which means, pretty much, it is as you see. Enders will win, unless he does something weird and dumb. Cujo will take second, Brody third, Mads fourth, and Mondo fifth. Everybody else did not qualify.
If Zev chooses, she could potentially mess with Enders.
She apparently has done that. Enders needs to... she's basically stopped on the bridge.
And Cujo is coming up. And catching. Gaining ground.
Zev is doing her best to get in the way of Enders.
Yeah, that's not cool. Somebody want to give Zev the big, you know, the heads up. Oh, okay, he's passed now. That's not that big a deal.
Jack is gaining ground. Mance is coming, and so is Mondo.
Yeah, Enders is passed now. Race. I don't think this is going to be a big deal. Brody seems to be bringing up the charge. Closing the distance on Cujo.
Ooh. And Captain... Yep, Mondo just went into the drink.
Ah, Mondo down.
He went off a meal, and he's done.
Oh, man. All right. Somebody bring Mondo down here. We got to accuse him of being a two-time bath participant. User was moved to your channel. Captain Mondo, you have been accused here forth of baptizing yourself twice. How do you plead?
Beer.
Was it in fact because you were drunk as hell?
No, it was just because I'm so far behind I figured what the hell.
Fair enough, I can respect that. I will commit watery seppuku.
Exactly.
Did
and realistically
bring
there's
Enders
no one
down
else I could
congratulate him on his victory.
Damage, so.
Exactly.
Yeah, I'll bring Enders in and we can congratulate him on his victory.
That sounds like an idea, because ain't nobody going to catch him now.
Oh, I don't know about that one. Oh, okay. Your channel.
Enders Tank, you, sir, will be victorious in your very first Grand Prix race. How does it feel?
Oh, I'd like to thank our Ranger and the boys for trading paint.
Thanks, everybody.
Hey, you've got beer and women in the commentating booth. That's nice. Didn't know that.
Heckler, don't kill him until they cross the line, if you would.
I'm not.
Thank you. We had somebody, you know, not pointing any fingers, J-Dog. Get a little excited.
Are you always going to remind me of that?
Yes. Yes, I will.
Bastard.
Zev gets away unscathed. I think she still thinks she's racing, which is kind of cute.
It's kind of commendable. She still wants to race.
Oh, wow. Mance avoids certain death. Mance is slippery.
Dodges the bullet.
I think we should deploy Heckler. Heckler, go terminate with extreme prejudice the bell ringer.
We'll
do. Currently up into A9.
Actually, she's killing herself right now.
No, she's in the drink.
Alright, that brings a halt to the festivities for the evening.
Quite a creature.
Congratulations and thank you, gentlemen.